Hey, Faith Community Church family, I'm not robbing Melinda. I'm just blessed to have her give us our 12 of 12 today, and just wanted to wear the mask for extra safety. Melinda, everyone knows and loves her from our church. She's our church secretary, been a blessing, and she's actually had a lot of different challenges beyond what we're experiencing right now with the COVID-19. So I asked her if she'd be willing to share, and she said yes, and this is going to be a blessing. So here's Melinda.
Hi, everybody. I miss everybody. I just had a few things I wanted to share today. Most of you probably know about my illness during this whole COVID thing. It's not COVID-19, but I have a rare disease called Addison's disease. And I've been in the hospital 4 days and then another day in emergency and not knowing what was wrong with me, with low blood pressure and low sodium and weak and fainty and vomiting and things like that, nausea. And so I have had to deal with this. Now that I have the medications, I'm getting better, but it's a long-term thing. I'll have the rest of my life, but I'm learning to deal with it, and the doctor's getting the medication right. So here I am on quarantine, pretty much not able to go out anywhere because I was ill. And then COVID-19 came and we all got to stay at home mandate. And so it's been a real interesting time to have to be isolated from people when everybody else is too. And the opportunities that have been brought to me during this time of videos and church and all these wonderful devotions so I can see people. And of course, more people are on Facebook and texting, and you know, so it's been like a hug from God that these coincided together. So my talk is going to be about joy. My dog would sit down. You can see my shirt says here, whoop, my lips will sing for joy. And I'm just going to talk a little bit about some of the things I've thought about having to just be home. You know, some of you've been home, but you've been able to be active at home and do things you wanted to do. And a lot of the time I just could just rest and sleep until I found out what was wrong, which took a few weeks to know. So I wanted to play a song that I woke up singing this morning because I was working on my joy topic, and this song came to my mind. So Dion's just going to put on the chorus for you.
Same God that never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. Yes, I will lift you high.
Those words just fit perfect for being in a low valley right now. And the words that say, yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. Yes, I will bless your name. Yes, I will sing for joy when my heart is heavy. And all my days, yes, I will. I choose to praise and glorify the name of all names that nothing can stand against. And when I was in the hospital, I mean, my blood pressure was so low and the doctors couldn't figure out why, and they kept giving me medication to keep it up, and it took them 4 days to finally get it to stay high enough that they could let me go home. And at that point, they still didn't know what was wrong. So the sodium buildup in my body enough to, it affects your adrenal glands, so that's the whole problem. And it's autoimmune, and it's just, affects so many areas of your body. And so they just couldn't figure out what was wrong until Dr. Bundy, thank God, was researching my symptoms. And he goes, I think I found out what it is. And Of course, my dear daughter Lisa goes online and gives me this whole list, and I had every symptom, and it's a long list of things that can be affected by it. So, but before I went in the hospital, the day before that, my dad passed away. And I had to be thankful for two reasons, because he had dementia for like about 3 years, and before that, he accepted Christ and was baptized in his 80s. And he was 93 when he died, and I know he's in heaven with Jesus. And I've been helping my parents all these months, and with Dad in and out of the hospital and on hospice, and if he would have still been here, it would have been terrible. And if it wouldn't have been for COVID, my family wouldn't have been all available to be there for my mom when I couldn't be. So there's just so many things to be thankful for and to have joy knowing that God sees me and he knows what I'm going through and he's providing and blessing. So I was actually in the hospital for a diverticulitis infection first, and that's what depleted my adrenal glands. And so that's what they thought, well, you're going to heal of that and you're going to be better, but that's when I didn't get better. So I missed that part. It was very important. So let's see, I had a bunch of things written down in a testimony I put on Facebook a while back, so I'm just kind of taking some highlights. And I mentioned the rest of the world stopping with me, and just all these wonderful Christian artists and putting their videos from their home. It's just like everybody's home with me. It's really cool. It's very personal, and it's, like I said, a big hug from God. Okay. And then, of course, my husband's retired, and he's been there for me cooking and cleaning, and I've dubbed him Hop Sing. If you've ever watched the old Bonanza, the Chinese cook and housekeeper was Hop Sing, so he's my Hop Sing. He loves Bonanza, so that worked for him. And I'm just thankful to all you guys who prayed for me, and you brought food for a while, and it's just been a big outpouring of love, and I praise God and love you all. So in all this, I've been thinking of choosing joy, because my whole post on Facebook was about being thankful in your circumstances and not grumbling and complaining, but looking for the things in your life that you can be thankful for. So I touched on a few of those. I was reading a devotion from my YouVersion app. It was really cool. And I kind of reworded it and added my own verses. So God's purpose for me, and it talks about how he wants us to show his love and his grace and his characters to the world. And so we all have a purpose. And a verse that really spoke to me right before I became secretary of our church, which is like 17 or 18 years ago, is Ephesians 2, 4, and 10. You are God's masterpiece, created in Christ Jesus to do good works. So that was the purpose-driven life series we did in our church years ago when Pastor Bart first came, and that verse really made me more confident and know that God could use me, and he has done good works through me that I'm really thankful, because I enjoy blessing you guys at church. And my job has never been a job, it's always been a ministry to me. And that he does have this a plan for us. He has a plan for you, he has a plan for me, and he wants us to be glad and look to the joy ahead in whatever it is. But what we need to do is trust him and obey him and dig into his word, because another verse that meant a lot to me as a new Christian, and that was over 40 some years ago, Psalm 119:105, your word is a lamp to guide my feet and a light for my path. And the devotional I read talked about following the light. He shines before us in his word. And all of Psalm 19 is all about being in love with God's word, who in the beginning was the word, and the word was God, and it was Jesus, you know? Jesus was the word. So you're in love with Jesus, you're in love with his words, and you take them in and they become a part of you. And it brings joy and reward in your life, because in accepting Jesus and his death on the cross, we have salvation. What more joy could we have knowing that we're saved from our sins and we'll spend eternity in heaven? And 1 Peter 1:8 talked about the joy You love him even though you have never seen him, and you trust him and rejoice with a glorious, inexpressible joy. Then it talked about God's power in me. So when we come to him and we spend time with him and we receive him into our heart, we get the Holy Spirit that enables us to become who God created us to be. And we can live our life through God's strength. And another verse that spoke to me through my life, Philippians 4:13, it is my life verse. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Me being a shy kind of person when I was younger and insecure, that verse really gave me the strength to step out of my comfort zone and do things for him. So we need to ask God to fill us with his power and the fruits of the Holy Spirit. So how exciting to have his power in you and to give you peace and joy and a love just to start, as well as all the other wonderful attributes of the Holy Spirit. And in all this, we need to pray, because we come to Christ, we read his word, but we are still human. We still fail, and we need to pray and ask God to change our hearts to be more like his. People who actually pray are the beneficiaries of heaven's power in their everyday lives. So we need to ask for the power to overcome and then wait for it as we continually pray. And a few weeks ago, I was angry about something, and I was angry at someone, and I was just stewing about it. And it was some repetitive thing that happens once in a while, and I just like, oh, you know, and you're like, God, don't they know better? Why are they doing this, you know? And I'm like so angry, just kind of a burning, gnawing anger. And all night I wrestled with that, feeling guilty, like, God, I don't want to feel this way every time. I want to repurpose my thoughts and try to have a more loving attitude, a more understanding, to look in someone's heart to see where their pain is coming from or their anger. And so all of a sudden, you know, I don't know about you, but when I wake up in the morning, I don't open my eyes for a while, and I'm just thinking all these thoughts, and you can hear birds all around here. And I look out towards Sacatana Mountains on the other side of me here. I have a beautiful view out here in Bardstown, and my bedroom's over here. And so when I open my eyes, I see the mountain. And so I hadn't opened my eyes yet, and I'm just praying, and God help me. And all of a sudden, he just had a thought come into my head that just let me release that anger. And I just felt this joy come over me, and I was just like, wow. And then I thought, I always have my phone by me, and I grab my phone, and I go, what's the verse of the day on the YouVersion app? Weeping may last for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Ah, Psalm 35:30, verse 5. And I just like, oh my gosh, you know, that is just for me. I mean, it has to be for a lot of people, but at that point, that was a verse that just spoke to my heart. So Jesus doesn't want me to act just like him, but he longs for me to be like him. So we don't act, but we be like him and change our heart. So all this leads to God's peace in my heart. Our emotions can run away with us. And God says, above all, guard your hearts, for it determines the course of your life. And that's Proverbs 4:23. Christians often tend to operate off of feelings rather than principle and truth. So let the Holy Spirit harness your emotions so you can be the person God intended you to be. So he doesn't want us to be angry. He doesn't want us to be hateful or, you know, vindictive. He wants us to love people and show them grace and mercy like he did to us. So the last thing I have is praise. So as a believer, you have the choice to either magnify your problems and your disappointments or magnify your God in spite of your problems. Praising in the lowest valleys and in the highest mountaintops. I've been through those low valleys lately. And my life is not about me. My life is about serving God and revealing his character in my world. So will you be remembered for the song in your heart? As you recognize God has a purpose and a plan for you, will you give his power to help you? Fill your mind with his word and prayer. Will you be filled with his praise? And my lips will sing with joy. My dog's in the way. That's all I had to say. And God bless all you guys. Bye-bye.